Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. This week we make a new thumb screw for the milling machine as I broke the original one off. This involves knurling, turning and cutting a thread using the die. We also set the DRO to give the size and the diameter of the part as we're making it. So let's go into the workshop and see how we did it.
The temperature in the workshop today is about 6-7 degrees Celsius, which is around 42 Fahrenheit. Today I want to make one of these screws. This fits in the mill on the collar. And you see it's snapped off. What happened was I wound this across and I didn't notice that this was under there, and of course as this part comes over it just snapped off the adjusting screw. I couldn't see it because of this was in the way. See, that goes out, and that adjusting screw there would be underneath the table. Although it was slack, it must have just caught the edge as I wound it out, snapped it off. So today's job is to make a replacement screw for this. There's the original one on the left, the broken one on the right.
Here's a drawing of the part we want to make. This is in metric, and I'll use my digital readout to convert back to imperial.
I've placed some mild steel in the lathe. Lathe set up. To go along 12 mil and turn it down to 5 mil.
Now, according to the digital readouts, this diameter should be 0.356.
Spot onto the digital readout. So although I've got an imperial mic, I can now change my readout over to metric.
and that gives me a reading of 9.05. So I want to go down to 5 mil on that.
Now on the mic it says 0.3045. On the digital readout, the reading is 0.3043. And if I press the button to change it to metric, it's 7.7 millimetres. Now if I move my tool along to the face where I've just finished, it says the length of the face is 12 millimetres. So now I need to turn the 8mm diameter down to 5mm, ready for the thread. Now the x-axis is giving me the diameter of the part, and the y-axis is giving me from the face to the length that I'm turning. According to the digital readout, the diameter is 6mm, so I'll put that back into Imperial, which should be 0.236.
2, 35, 36, 38.
According to the digital reading, that should be 5mm, which is 0.19685.
The reading on here is 197.2, so it's within about 5/10 of the size.
The digital scales are in metric and the resolution is 5 microns, and then it's converted to Imperial.
So that in is 5 millimetres going to the scale, and 5 millimetres is 19685. So now I need to put chamfer on there so the die will have a good lead in. Right, I've got my 5mm die in the die holder. That fits onto the bar I have in the tailstock, the guide bar. Put some oil. Then by turning my headstock,
using the mandrel I made so I can put a spanner on the end of the headstock, I can turn it by hand.
I can start to cut the thread. Up to the face. You can see that's just touched the face now. Back out the die. There's the thread. What I'll do is with the file just round off the beginning of the thread. Back on just to clear the thread. Okay. So the next thing to do is make the knurl on the outside. I've set my knurling tool in the tool holder. I've squared the tool up to the chuck. Now I just want to put a small knurl on the edge of this bar. That's a knurl I've put on. I don't need it too sharp, it doesn't need to be too deep. So now I'll just take the corner off here, take the corner off the here and start to part this off. So if you look at the pattern, that's what we're making. I'll put a bit more of a chamfer on the edge.
I'll change the tool to my parting off tool.
Slow the speed down.
I've taken a piece of brass that has a 5mm thread in it, screwed in the screw into the brass. I'm holding the brass in a 3-jaw chuck so I can face off the front of the screw. Doing is using the edge of the tool to form a dome on the part with some emery cloth. Just polish the dome. Here's a new screw. That just goes into there. And when you need to, you can lock the dial on this to the spindle. When you want to reset it, slacken the screw, turn it to wherever you need.
Well, that's it for this week. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.